Facebook. Stop using this dangerous platform.
How did it know we were just talking about that? Is my phone listening?
We live off-grid on 4.5 acres of land.
Our GPS constantly monitors our location. Cell towers monitor our location.
Tor is a powerful tool to keep your information safe, routing your traffic through Tor nodes to anonymize you.
Listen, I respect each of these people, but let's be honest. These tips are a great option for some folks, but in reality, for most of us, it's not only unattainable, it's often overkill. But here's the good news. You don't have to wear a tinfoil hat to take control of your privacy. In fact, just a few simple changes can dramatically reduce how exposed you are and how much of your data is being collected, tracked, and sold. So today I'm gonna walk us through 11 easy privacy tips that anyone can do. No tech background required, no tinfoil hat necessary. This video is sponsored by Yubico, one of the easiest no-brainer steps that you can take to secure your online privacy. You don't have to change how you browse the internet, just the tool you're using to do it. Most big tech browsers leak your data like a sieve. Cookies, trackers, and even device fingerprint can follow you around the internet. That's why switching to a privacy-focused browser like Brave, which is what I use, or Firefox with some privacy tweaks, or even Molvad browser is one of the easiest upgrades that you can make today. These browsers are designed to block third-party trackers by default and minimize the unique data points that advertisers use to build a digital profile on you. Remember this. When you email anything to anyone, your control over that data is completely lost once it hits their inbox. That's why you don't want to email documents with sensitive information on it. It's also why good banking institutions require you to upload your financial documents via a secure portal and not as an email attachment. A better alternative is to use encrypted, privacy-first tools like Send This File, Wormhole, or even do something like Proton Drive. These services allow you to share files that are end-to-end encrypted and set an auto-delete after a certain amount of time or a certain number of downloads. It's like sending a self-destructing package, except only the recipient can open it and nobody else. There is no such thing as private social media, as you've heard me say in previous videos, but I am shocked how much personal data most people leave wide open and publicly available on their social media profiles. Birthdays, family photos, location check-ins. That's a gold mine for identity thieves, scammers, and even stalkers. Take just 5 minutes to dive into your privacy settings and lock things down. On Instagram, go into the settings, account privacy, and toggle on private account setting. In Facebook, go into the settings and make all data friends only. And on LinkedIn, visit settings, visibility, and change these things how you see fit. You want to control who can see your posts and photos without actually being connected to you. And finally, if you have a 2FA security key like this one from Yubico, now is a good time to use it to add the strongest level of protection for every social account. This isn't about being antisocial, it's about being smart. If your laptop were stolen today, could a stranger access all your files? If your drive isn't encrypted, the answer is yes. Full disk encryption ensures that even if your computer falls into the wrong hands, your data stays secure. On Windows, turn on BitLocker. On macOS, enable what's known as File Vault. It's usually just a setting toggle, no tech wizardry required, and it protects everything stored on your machine behind your login credentials. In addition to encrypting your hard drive, I highly recommend you take steps to encrypt and lock down your mobile device, especially for those of you using an iPhone. By adding two-factor authentication, you ensure that nobody else can sign into your account on a new device or without your consent. I've done a whole video explaining how to do this. But in short, you just go into settings, click on your name, find sign in and security, and then scroll down to find two-factor authentication. Keep in mind that this only works on newer devices. So if you still hold on to older tech, you might be limited in what you can do here. Strong passwords are great, but if that's all you're relying on, you're still vulnerable. Two-factor authentication adds an important but very easy extra layer of protection. And security keys, like YubiKey, are the gold standard. Unlike codes sent via text or an authenticator app, hardware keys can't be phished. They require physical presence, and they work instantly with supported sites. It's one of the strongest defenses you can have against account takeovers. This video has been made possible by Yubico, who have been a longtime supporter of All Things Secured. But even without their sponsorship, I've always recommended these keys. I personally have multiple keys that I use to store passkeys, lock my accounts, and verify my identity. Upgrade your account security with $5 off your next YubiKey purchase by visiting allthingssecured.com/YubiKey5off. This old photo of Mark Zuckerberg, where his computer is seen with tape over the camera, is proof that you don't need expensive tools to improve your privacy. Your webcam and your computer screen are windows into your life, and any kind of cheap webcam cover can block spying attempts, whether from rogue apps or actual malware. A privacy screen for your phone makes it hard for shoulder surfers to see what you're doing in public. These low-tech tools don't require configuration and cost less than a cup of coffee in many cases, yet they protect against high-tech snooping. Think of them as physical shields in your digital defense strategy. If you're like most people, you tend to have a mix of both your work and your personal life on the same computer and phone. Mixing everything into one digital folder may be convenient, but it's a recipe for disaster. If a hacker gets access to one part of the system, they shouldn't be able to roam freely through everything. So start separating your digital life. Use different cloud folders, user profiles, or even separate encrypted volumes for sensitive data. It not only makes breaches harder, but also makes organizing and backing up easier. Removing yourself from the gaze of big tech companies doesn't require a complete change of everything. In fact, it's sometimes best to make one small step at a time by finding private alternatives to the apps you use most often. For example, you could look into Jitsi instead of Zoom, Signal instead of Facebook Messenger, OSM&, instead of Google Maps, or you could even watch this video on Odyssey instead of YouTube if you wanted to. Take little steps at a time to see what works for you. Your real phone number, email address, and home address shouldn't be your default identifiers online. There are so many different ways to mask this email, phone number, physical address, even your credit card. And instead of trying to explain it all here, I'll just point you to this playlist I've made of different videos explaining it all. The idea is just to keep your real details private while still letting you sign up for services, fill out forms, or respond to messages. It's one of the most practical ways to avoid spam, scams, and data breaches. At least once a year, I recommend taking the easy step of simply going through your phone and deleting any and all apps that you don't regularly use. Then, once you've finished that, go into the permissions for each app, including camera, microphone, and GPS permissions, to make sure that each app is only allowed to use what you want it to have access to. Less exposure equals less risk, and this applies to pretty much any device that you have. These are some of the easiest changes you can make, and if you want to go even deeper, check out this video about 7 cybersecurity tips most people never tell you. Finally, the easiest way to have the greatest impact on your online privacy and security is to get a 2FA security key. So visit allthingssecured.com/YubiKey5off to get an exclusive discount on your next security key.